skin. We came to battle, came to fight. Yeah, we came to win. Wings up, we're making our ascent to the clouds with the sound like a roaring lion. It feels like our time is now. It feels like we were born to be champions.
This is the Whittier Weekly for the week of September 23rd.
Please stand for the pledge.
We sure had a great week last week having you in our building for SCP conferences. That is such an important appointment with your students, teachers, to know how they're doing and how you can work together as a team for success for your students. Also, we thank all of you who came to our special guest lunch last Thursday. It was awesome. We had several, I would say a couple hundred people here. Thanks for coming and supporting your students. Also, if you are not receiving your texts from Whittier, we text at least weekly with the Whittier Weekly link on it. But if you aren't getting those, that means we don't have your correct and updated information. So if that is the case, please go to the office sometime real soon and update your phone number and email so you can get our texts and our emails so that you can stay updated on the latest that's happening at Whittier.
Let's check out our Whittier Rewind.
Truth. Ooh.
Sixth grade was winning attendance for September. Let's see who's winning now. We know that kindergarten are learning their letters and sounds. Two got it. Let's watch.
Give me an A!
A!
Give me an A!
What is this
now?
Liam!
Liam! Woohoo!
Why are we celebrating you?
Because me and I know our letters and our students.
All right, kindergartners, you're parts of the ABC Pizza Club. Why?
It's our kindergarten teachers here. We're practicing our letters for the second time. This is the letter D. D says D, dolphin. D, D, dolphin.
A says ah, 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 apple.
Ah, ah, apple.
This is the letter M, and it says
This is the letter J. Get your jump ropes out. J, J. And the letter N. N is my nose. Nose.
Yay!
Yay, bye!
Here are more students that's showing off their writing.
Listen, baseball is easy to learn. It requires skill and a little luck. Most people think you just hit a ball across the field with a metal stick, but it's a lot more complicated than that. There are the bases and the pitcher's mound where the pitcher stands. The pitcher is the person that throws the ball for the batter to hit. When you are the batter, you stand next to home base. Then the pitcher throws the ball for the batter to hit. Unlike most sports where you score points, in baseball you score runs. When you get a run, if you hit all the way to home base, how the bases work is if you hit first, then you'll run to the first base. If you hit a double, then you run to second base. If you hit a triple, then you run to third base. If you hit a home run, then you run all the bases. But baseball is not all just hitting the ball. The other team needs to hit too. So be a catcher. When you're are the catching, you get to stand on the base when the other team hits. Your goal is, in this part, is to catch the balls the other team hits. If you catch them before they hit the ground, they are out. And at the end of the game, whoever has the most runs wins. So go out there and start playing baseball.
Did you know William Kawamba made a windmill? Well, his dad had family struggle. William's dad's crops in his yard died, so it motivated William to make a windmill. William's life changes when his family didn't have money. William went to the library. He found a book about how to build a windmill. So he went home, then thought about how his family could have energy in their house. And a windmill could be used to pump water to hydrate his family field. In the end, William made a windmill, then his dad's crops could be made. And in Africa, they can have energy and water. And now his dad can have money.
My favorite animal is a dog. My favorite animal is a dog. I like that. They are fluffy, they are fluffy, and they are so cute.
I remember when rock was
That's it for us.
Have a great week.
We were born to be champions.